Now we will see the problems in direct products. So the first one, if G is the direct product of H and K, then we have to show that G is abelian if and only if H and K are abelian. So first we shall assume that H to be abelian and establish that H and K are abelian. So for which, if we consider H1 and H2, we will consider H1 and H2 to be members of our two elements in capital H. So once we prove it for H, in the same way we can prove it for K. So first we shall establish it, establish that H is abelian whenever G is abelian. So because G is abelian, if we consider H1E, which is a member of G, and H2E again a member of G, they two will commute. So we can write like this. And Cartesian product is defined component wise. So H1, H2, E, that is the first element, whatever we have on the left side, can be rewritten as this way. And on the right side, in the same way, component wise multiplication. So you have H2, H1. So by the equality of ordered pairs, we have the first component to be same as the first component of the right side. So H1, H2 is equal to H2, H1. So this proves that H is abelian. The same way K can be proved to be, K can be established as an abelian group. Right. Conversely, if H and K are abelian, then we have to show that G is abelian for which you consider two elements, say HK, H dash, K dash. Then that gives you HH dash, KK dash. That is, your H and K are abelian, so you can rewrite it as H dash H, K dash K. And again, rewriting this, you get this. And that shows G is abelian. Now, the second one, if P and Q are distinct primes, then ZPQ can be expressed as a direct product of cyclic group of order P and a cyclic group of order Q. ZPQ is expressed as the product of ZP and ZQ. Okay, so this is what we are trying to prove. So you take G as ZPQ and you take H to be a subgroup of G of order P. So any group of order prime order is always cyclic. So we shall take H to be generated by, say, some J. H is taken to be a subgroup generated by J. H is a subgroup of order P and therefore it is cyclic. So it will have a generator. Take the generator as J. And the same way, K be a subgroup of G of order Q, right? Then K is also cyclic. You take the generator for K to be I. K is the subgroup generated by I, and H is generated by J. Now, we would like to show that our G, namely ZPQ, is nothing but H and M, the product of H and K, the product of H and K. So, for which we shall consider, see, the idea is this, that is, we know very well that HK, order of HK is equal to order of H into order of K divided by order of H intersection K. So if I am able to prove that my denominator is 1, then this will be order of H is P and order of K is Q, and this is nothing but order of G. So both of them, this HK and G, both of them are of the same order and one is contained in the other. HK is contained in G is always known because H is there in G. K is also present in G as a subgroup. So this is contained in G. And both of them are of the same order means then we will have G to be equal to, G will be equal to HK. And H is the subgroup of G of order P. And we know that any group which is of order P is isomorphic to ZP. And similarly, any group K which is of order Q is isomorphic to ZQ. So we can have our we can also have from this that ZPQ is ZP cross ZQ. This is actually in the statement we want to show that it's a direct product of cyclic group of order P and cyclic group of order Q. Not we are not directly asked to show that ZPQ is equal to ZP cross ZQ, but we have taken one to be H, the other one to be K. So what we would arrive at is ZPQ is equal to HK only. But it is equivalent to say that ZPQ can also be expressed in this way. Right. So, so job now is just to show that order of H intersection K is 1. So for which we have to show that H intersection K is just a singleton E. Now you consider, so we will prove this separately. We shall consider X in X to be a member of H and K, right? So that we have order of X. So this implies that X belongs to H and K. X belongs to H as well as X belongs to K. Now this in turn implies order of X divides order of H, the corollary to Lagrange's theorem. So this in turn implies X to the power order of H is P. X power P is P. Right. So, and in the same way here, we have this order of X dividing order of K. So that in turn implies, that in turn implies that X power Q is, but very obviously P and Q are relatively prime. P is a prime number, Q is a prime number, so they are relatively prime. So when we consider MP plus NQ, we can find integers M and N such that MP plus NQ is equal to 1. This implies this. Therefore, if we consider X to the power MP plus NQ, it will be equal to, see we have we have MP, because X power P is E, X power MP is E, and similarly Q, X power Q is E, so X power that is also, so the whole lot is nothing but, when we consider this, because of this, we conclude that, so I am skipping that step, so we conclude that this is nothing but E. So this is X, you consider X to be an element in this and you have got that X to be just E. So H intersection K consists of only one element, therefore order of H intersection K should only be 1. And that in turn gives the order of HK to be equal to order of H into order of A, which is PQ and which is nothing but order of G. So one is containing the other, both of them are of the same order, therefore equality holds. So G is expressed as the direct product of cyclic group of order P and a cyclic group of order Q. The next is we have to show that the dihedral group D4 cannot be expressed as a product of two proper subgroups. So for which we shall consider that suppose it is expressed. And then we arrive at a contradiction. So we shall consider two subgroups. One is of order 2, the other one is of order 4. So like that we will consider two subgroup, proper subgroups, say H and K. Then one is of order 2 and the other one K must be of order 4. Like that we will take. and we will consider the group row 1 generated by row 1, the cyclic subgroup generated by row 1 is the only cyclic group of order 4 and it is abelian, let it be K, and let H be any subgroup of order 2, then H is also abelian because order only 2 elements, so it has to be that one because it's cyclic, it's abelian, and this one is abelian because its order is 2. So H cross K, just now we proved that if H and K are abelian, then H cross K is abelian. So we have D4 to be H cross K. So in that case, your D4 becomes the abelian group, but D4 is not an abelian group. So we can, what we can conclude from this is D4 cannot be expressed as a direct product of two proper subgroups. See, here we have considered, see, actually there are three subgroups. There are three subgroups in D4 which is of order, which are of order 4. So of which one is this, the other two also. So if you go to the preliminaries, we have given the subgroups of D4, there we can consider. So the other two subgroups will also be abelian. They are not cyclic, but they are abelian. So in that case, we don't have any possibility of our D4 being expressed as H cross K. One is of order 4, the other one to be of order 2, because both of them are abelian on the right side, but D4 is not abelian. So you cannot express D4 as the product of two proper subgroups of D4. If P is a prime number, show that the cyclic group, we are given ZP square to be a cyclic group of order P square. We are asked to show that this is indecomposable. Right. Now first we notice that the subgroups of ZP square are singleton 0, ZP square, the other one is any subgroup which is of order P, but any group which is of order P is isomorphic to ZP. So these are the possible subgroups. So if it has to be expressed as product of two proper subgroups, naturally these two won't come, these two, this one and this one will not come. So we have to depend only on H. So the only possibility for ZP square to be expressed as product of two proper subgroups, it's only this. But we are going to say that even this possibility is ruled out for the reason that we have on the left side in ZP square class 1 to be of order P square in ZP square, but there exists no element in ZP cross ZP of order P square. Any element in ZP can at the most be of order P only, and similarly here also P. So we have altogether, when we consider any AB to be a member of ZP cross ZP, at the most the order can only be P. You cannot find any element which is of order P square. So if you are expressing like this, means we must have an element over here also to be of order P square, which is not possible. Therefore, this is indecomposable. So the next one, this is repeatedly asked question in section A. If A, B are cyclic groups of order M and N respectively, then A cross B is cyclic if M and N are relatively prime. So for this, the technique used is this. Any group G is cyclic. Once you are able to obtain an element in G, such that order of G and order of that element is the same. Only for a cyclic group, only for a cyclic group, you have order of the element to be equal to order of the group. So it is this technique. This technique is used in proving this problem. You take A to be a cyclic group of order M generated by N. So order of A, M in the same way, B generated by B, cyclic group of order N. We have given that M and N are relatively prime. So we need to show that A cross B is cyclic by claiming that AB, see, we have got A and B. So we are going to prove that AB is a generator for this group A cross B. So to prove that, we have to prove that order of AB. See, if I am able to prove that AB act as the generator for my A cross B. Remember, we have already proved that A cross B is can be expressed as this also, because a internal direct product is isomorphic to external direct product. So this is there. So any element here, whether I express it as order pair AB or this, it doesn't matter. But so that is one thing, but whether we are going to use or not, we will see. But this is also there, one point, but we can notice, even though we may not require, but we can think in that line also. But that is not discussed here. So right, so we'll prove that this A cross B, which is of order A cross B, is of order Mn. Order of A cross B is Mn. And if I am able to produce an element in A cross B which is also of order Mn, then A cross B will be cyclic, generated by that order pair AB. So that is the technique. So you consider order pair AB in A cross B. Now you consider AB par Mn. So you can write this as, because AB, 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 Mn times, so which means that component wise multiplication. So you will have A par Mn, B par Mn, and that is rewritten as A par M par N, B par N par M. And here either you use identity element E or 1. So here we have used 1. So this is of order, see, it is cyclic. So generator as well as the group will have the same order. So A par N is 1, and in the same way B par N is 1. So it is the least positive integer M for which A par N is 1. Least positive integer n for which b par n is 1. So automatically this you get. Now we want to show that this mn is the least, and we want to show that this mn is the least. So for which what we consider is, we will have some other integer d, a b par d is identity element, right? So this again will imply a par d b par d to be 1 1. This is 1, and b par d is it is it is not a par d 1 b par d 1, it is a b par d is 1, because you have assumed, this is your assumption, for some other integer a b par that integer gives me identity element, this is your assumption. This alone, with that we simplify, this remains as such. And we know very well already that a par m b par n is also 1 1, whereas this is the least positive integer, and this is, as far as a is concerned, any other integer. So least must divide any other, least must divide any other. So you have m dividing d, n dividing d, and m and n are relatively prime. So if m and n are relatively prime, then the product m n should divide d. So this how we are getting, so that you think and tell me that how do we get. See, we are given only m dividing d, n dividing d. This doesn't mean that mn has to divide d, right? So if it has to divide d, means you have to have m and n are relatively prime. Proof can be easily given, so you think over and tell me. So thus mn is the least positive integer. So this we will arrive at. What is the condition? M divides D known, N divides D known, M and N relatively prime implies M and divides D, right? So so M n is the least positive integer for which A B par M n is 1, that is identity element. So order of A plus B, and this is same, so A plus B must be cyclic. Now the other three problems. Once we prove 6th one, we can easily establish 7th one. Once 7th is established, we can easily establish the 8th one. So that is how it goes. What is the 6th problem? What is the 6th problem? Prove that G is the internal direct product of this, if and only if G is n1 n2 and so on nn and ni intersection. So in this you will not have ni other than ni in the product whatever you have. So the intersection of these two you have to show it to be symmetric. If we have just two, we have already shown that ni intersection nj is singleton e, that we have established. The concept is extended here. So product, you have one and the other, and this is one side, the rest are on the other side, the intersection is singleton e. Now we are given g to be internal direct product. So in the definition we have g being written as n1 n2 and so on nn. So it is enough to prove the second one. So you consider x to be element on the left hand side. If you are able to show that x is e, then you are through. So you consider x to be a member of ni intersection the product nj. This stands for the product product nj. So x belongs to ni and x belongs to the product. Right? Where when you have a, b, c, you can simply write this as product a. A, b, c stands for product a. Likewise, you have this. So x is ni and x is also in this product. So because x is in ni, you can write like this. And because x belongs to this product, we can write x to be m1 is in the first group n1 and so on. So whatever we have here n I, in that place we are going to replace that by EI. Remember EI is same as E, right? This is what we have by uniqueness. So my X is written as this, X belongs to this, X is also in G. So I can write like this, and X is in this, but X is also present in G. So we have got two expression for the same X, but by uniqueness they have to be the same, and therefore we have this x to coincide with this, and therefore you have x is equal to ei is equal to e. So the intersection x is considered to be an element in the intersection, and that happens to be 9e, and therefore this is singleton e. Now for the converse part, we shall assume 1 and 2 to be true. We have to show that g is the internal direct product. So in the definition of internal direct product, whatever you are given as the first condition, it holds. So to establish the second one, that is the uniqueness, we proceed like this. Suppose we have x to be in G as what? Two representation. X is written as x1 etc. xn, and x is also written as y1 etc. yn. Then we can equate these two. So we can argue like this. See, this one, when we have only two, then in that case, we said already that ni intersection nj is singleton e. So, suppose I have only two elements, say. Let us establish it for two elements. In the same way, we can have it for n number of elements. So, let x be x1, x2 and y be y1, y2. Right? So, I mean x is not y, x is also written as two representation for the same x. So what you have is x1 x2 is equal to y1 y2, right? Then you take you pre-multiply both sides by y1 inverse, and this one y2 x2 inverse post-multiply. So, but whatever you have on the left side is a member of N1. If we have just two, we are talking about this N1, and this one is an N2. So, but an element which is present in N1 as well as in N2 can only be identity element by the condition given. So, in that case, what we have is X1 to be equal to Y1. And similarly, x2 is equal to y2. So, proceeding like this, we can easily establish that we can have the same concept extended. So, you can have y and xn inverse to be in one the rest are in the other one, but their intersection is singletonly. Therefore, each x I must be equal to y I for all I. Right, the seventh one, it depends on the previous result. So the statement goes like this: if G is a finite group and n1 etc. n are normal in G, such that the first condition is G is the just the direct internal direct product. Here it is dot, not comma. The second one is order of n1, order of n2, and so order of nn is equal to order of n1, the product. This is given. Here it is not if or if condition. We have to just assuming this, we have to show that G is the direct product of n1 etc. nn. For to prove this, we are going to make use of this. To prove this, we are going to make use of this. So, how we write this one? To start with, we consider this. How we can write this? See, this we are already familiar with. Order of hk is equal to order of k divided by order of h intersection k. So we make use of that. You treat this as k, and this one as h. Idum group na, right? Because each one is normal, so the product of the normal subgroups is again a subgroup. In fact, normal itself. So this is written as order of k divided by order of h intersection k. Then, so what we are going to do, again we are going to repeat the same thing for this one, the same thing for the next one. See, it is something like this that we have. We have to consider HKL. So with the three, if we can establish this, then for n we can, because for 2 it is too obvious, so we should go with 3 subgroups. We should take them as a order of h k l, 3 subgroups that we will consider. You know that this can be written as order of h, order of k l divided by order of h intersection k l. Now what we do is we consider this, so it will be order of h, order of k, order of l, okay, divided by, already in the denominator this one is present, so h intersection k l, and then for this one it is order of k, order of l. So like this that you will have. So in this order of ni, order of n1 and so on this. So you will have order of ni intersection the product nj, the same thing we had, order of h intersection this, and this is going to be some form, this is an integer, this is an integer, so some positive integer. So this is what we get. So that is written here, some positive integer that you have. And you are given order of n1 etc. nn to be order of n1, order of n2 and so on, order of nn. So that is there on the left side. So that means here what I have, what is given to me? Order of h, order of k, order of l is equal to this one you have, and this you have, and this is some integer. So you can cancel this with this. So you'll be left with order of h intersection kl into some integer is equal to 1. So this is what you have. Okay, some positive integer into this one gives 1. So that means each one has to be 1 because all are integers. So you cannot have fraction here to get cancelled. So this one should be 1, order of this one should be 1, which means ni intersection this one should be symmetric E. So that is the second condition that we have stated here. So first condition here, and you have arrived at the second condition. If this is the case, the converse part of that tells me that G is the internal direct product, but internal direct product and external direct product are isomorphic, and therefore there is no distinction between them. So we conclude that G is the direct product of n1 etc. nn. And the last problem, if G is a finite abelian group, then G is the direct product of its P pseudo subgroups. See, given any positive integer, we know by fundamental theorem on arithmetic that M is written as product of prime powers. And it's very obvious that P1 per alpha 1 will divide order of G, and you cannot add one more prime to that to divide order of G. So it does not divide order of G. So by the definition of P1 pseudo subgroup, G has a P1 pseudo subgroups, you name it as S1 of order P1 power alpha 1. And G has another P2 pseudo subgroup, name it as S2 of order P2 power alpha 2 and so on. So you will have n number of, pseudo subgroups, each one is of order P1 power alpha 1, P2 power alpha 2 and so on, right? And we can have order of S1, order of S2, and this is nothing but P1, P1 power alpha 1 and so on, Pn power alpha n. And that is nothing but your order of G. So that is nothing but order of G. And the all these products are obviously contained in G. And this one, order of S1 and so on, this is nothing but order of the group G. I mean, order of this product S1, etc., Sn. So order of G is equal to order of this, and one is contained in the other, and therefore G itself should be like this. G is the direct product of P pseudo subgroup. This is a P pseudo subgroup. Yeah, particularly speaking, P1 pseudo subgroup, P2 pseudo subgroup. So generalizing that, just P pseudo subgroup. So G is the direct product of its P pseudo subgroups. How we get that this one to be equal to this is, they are all, see, the same thing what we have established here, the same justification we can give, and what we have is, so the same justification we can give, so you can have it as, because the individual intersection when we consider, it will be just simultaneity, and therefore they will contribute in the order to be just one. So you can have this one to be equal to this. So in that way, one is containing the other, both of them are of the same order, is established. So this one follows. To do the problem, hints are given, so you can go through and do them.